Hello, children. Are you ready for some cutting up and kicking? Are you ready for a gay old time? Well, I hope you are, because now it's time for Hey Queen with your host, Johnny McGovern.
Hey Queen, come on and spill the tea. Hey Queen, it's just a good old fashioned kiki. Hey Queen, we're cutting up with Johnny. Hey, 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 hey Queen.
My faggoty children, and welcome to another look-filled episode of Hey Queen, with me, your host, Johnny McGovern. Oh, we have a cunty show for you today. Well, I'm very excited. Things are getting controversial. The fourth Kardashian is here, Miss Trinity K. Bonet. Oh, I'm excited to bring her out. But before we do, there's another very special someone I have to introduce. She'll read you faster than a housewife's new copy of 50 Shades of Grey. If you come for her, she'll greet you with open arms and a razor blade in her weeds. And just like a Washington, D.C. madam, she'll leave you gagged every time. It's Miss Lady Red Couture. Yeah. Oh, hey, Queen.
You.
Oh, yes. Normally, I'd be like, well, look at you, but you know what? Look at me.
Look at you.
What? Look at me.
Are we trying to go for a new demographic? Mm-hmm.
What can I say, Lady Red? All I can say is I'm a dom top leather daddy too. Yeah. Oh, fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. Come on, boy. Oh. Come on, you fucker.
Lady Red, be scared. Be very afraid.
I was just trying to fit in. You know, I got my little leather.
Yeah, Lady Red, I'm taking you down to the Folsom Street Fair.
Uh-uh.
They're going to tie you up and titty torture you. You're like, let go of my titties. I'm actually wearing gear from Rough Trade Gear in Silver Lake.
Rough Trade Gear?
Rough Trade Gear. In case you wonder what kind of trade it was,
It's rough trade.
I hosted the Mr. L.A. Leather.
Oh, my goodness.
It was a pageant, really. Okay, Mr. L.A. Leather pageant.
Yes, yes.
So in case you don't know about Mr. L.A. Leather, all of the leather bars or leather-adjacent bars around the L.A. area nominate a gentleman, a queen, a leather queen, to be a man queen, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
To be their Mr. whatever. So Mr. Eagle L.A. Leather, Mr. Oil Gang Harry's, Mr. Butch Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence, et cetera, et cetera.
Okay.
And then they all come together.
Yeah.
Downtown at the Globe Theater.
Oh.
Let me tell you, this is a fancy motherfucking show.
Yes.
And they promenade, and they parade, and they be judged, and they have to ask questions.
Uh-huh.
It's like a Miss America pageant, but for Harry Leather Daddies.
Wow.
And I was the host. It was really fun.
That's awesome. All that leather, cowhide, and sweat.
That's what they like, Lady Rails, I found out. The leather and the sweat mix. For manly mix.
Wet, smelly leather.
Yeah, you're already getting in.
Okay, that's enough of that.
Well, appropriately enough, there's another leather scary looking lady in the house today. It's our guest band leader, Erica Toravias, and the Wake Up Wave.
Wow.
She's dressed as Evil Mickey today.
Yes. Go on, Manika.
Manika?
That's what I'm going to call you, Manika.
Girl. Manika Musay.
Yes.
Manika Musay.
Yeah, Manika Musay.
Yes,
I love that.
Oh, Manika Musay. What you going to do?
I left all my accoutrements at home. I wasn't aware.
But I
wasn't prepared. I would have brought some sort of chaps or harness.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I mean, that's wonderful. I'm a little terrified all the way over here.
Well, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I try.
Lyrica would have loved the men's at this pageant.
Oh, I know,
honey.
She would have.
You, Erica, you would have been sniffing a pit. You would have loved this.
I do love. Well, anything, really.
Anything. Anything.
You're so filthy. I love you.
Well, it's good that we're wearing our bondage BDSM gear today.
We got this.
Because we got a naughty girl in the house.
What?
The bad girl in drag.
Yeah, son!
Oh, honey. She stepped in a pile of controversy.
Oh, shit.
And luckily, her first stop was where? Hey, Queen, yes. To tell the truth, tell her story, and get herself out of some trouble. The beautiful and talented Trinity K. Bonet is here today.
Yay!
Well, we got a lot to go on, so we'll be with her right after this very gay break. Hit it, Erica!
Trinity K.
Uh-huh.
Trinity K. Bonet.
Uh-huh.
Trinity K. Bonet.
Trinity.
Oh.
Trinity K.
Uh-huh.
Trinity K. Bonet.
Uh-huh.
Trinity K. Bonet.
Oh, Carl.
Johnny here to let you know about our brand new website, heyqueen.tv. Not only do we have every single episode from every season of Hey Queen, but all of our side shows, Hot Tea, Judge Lady Red, He's Fit, Lady Red's Corner, Drag Cousins, Whoa Dude, and more. And most importantly, we have our brand new t-shirt shop with brand new t-shirt designs, including Every Boner is a Blessing. Hey Queen. Look at her. Hello, children. Yes, queen. Plus, tank tops for whores for the summertime. And don't forget, wear your Hey Queen shirts with me and Lady Red on them to show your support for everything Hey Queen. Buy them at heyqueen.tv.
Today we have a beautiful and talented queen on the show, but honey, she just stirred them all up recently with a little video that we're gonna talk a lot about. But let's welcome her beauty, Trinity K. Bonet! Yay!
Trinity K. Trinity K. Bonet.
Yeah. Trinity K. Bonet.
Trinity.
Trinity K. Bonet.
Oh, Carl.
There she
it's
is.
It's some real classy shit y'all got going on.
That is the reaction we like. This is some classy shit. Sparkly as hell.
Yes, it is.
Trinity K. Bonet. Serving body, honey.
Just something I pulled out my closet for you.
Oh, yes.
I didn't know how you was going to be feeling today. I was feeling cultural.
Oh, well, good.
Yeah.
I'm feeling cultural as well. Yeah. I'm a different kind of culture.
Okay, come on. Let's go.
All right. Let's go. Let's begin. Okay, Trinity. Now, as if it was meant just to stir up controversy right before you came on the show, which I really appreciate, you made a video just a couple days ago that started off, why the fuck?
Yeah!
All these local queens. So bitter about our drag race, girl. And if it started up here, honey, oh, we kept going to the damn. You were having a moment.
Yeah.
Shall we talk about what led up to that making of that video?
Yes, we can definitely talk about. Okay, first and foremost, let's just put it out there that I am a horrible speaker. Well, first of all, RuPaul Drag Race do not give you media training after you get off the show.
Yes, that's
so
true.
I am not media trained. I really don't speak with a filter. I'm from the South, and we say what we mean, and we mean what we say. But that's one little portion of the world compared to everybody and everybody who watches me and supports us. So I don't know how to speak on camera. and it comes across extremely rude. So, do me a favor. Mm. At any point in this interview, if I seem aggressive or angry or bitter, let me know.
I'll be like,
that's my cue, you know? And I want people to know that, you know, I'm a work in progress and I'm learning. And,
right.
and looking back at myself, I was wrong in my delivery.
Mm.
I was completely wrong in my delivery because it could have been said a lot better. It could have been said clearer and people would have understood better.
Yeah.
But I was angry.
Uh-huh.
That's a true fact. I was angry and everything that I said came from some true shit. You know, all of this stuff came from places where and things that I've experienced. And
did something pop off right before you made that video? Get your drink.
Let me hold on.
Yep, take a sip and let the truth tea be spilled. She's prepared statement.
Come on.
She's got a prepared statement.
No, this shit is important.
Okay, yeah, it
this
is.
This is important.
This
because
is your time to clear it up because you're going to be going to some places with local queens.
Yeah.
And I don't want them to be like, look at her.
You know, this is some important stuff, and the reason why I want to clarify everything that I said is because everything that I said in my video was truth.
Uh-huh.
Nothing I said was a lie. I didn't make any of these things up,
right.
But I did not explain myself. Mm. I just spoke on it
right.
with no explanation
you
behind
just
it.
You just opened their mouth up and said, here's some hot sauce,
yeah.
motherfucker.
Yeah, I just spoke on it, so I want to clear things up.
Okay.
As far as it leading up to why I said what I said, two events happened. Well, several things happened. I've traveled for the last 2 years as a contestant on RuPaul's Drag Race. And in those travels, I have heard cast members at clubs, promoters, different people drag my sisters, throw them under the bus for whatever irresponsible things they may have done on the road.
Uh-huh.
They're not welcome back. Oh, I'll never have her again. I'll never do this. I'll never do that. I come from a place where if you're my sister, you're my sister. This is a sorority. We're all a part of this together. So I'm offended when I hear people talk about them to me. You can talk about them amongst yourselves and your girlfriends, but that's my girlfriend. So why do you feel like it's okay for you to bash them to me? And that bothers me. I hear it so often. Recently, I was in St. Louis, and I did a booking. Now, let me also say, I never said that the girls were reading me.
Mm-hmm.
I said that they were reading Drag Race in general.
Mm.
But I went on a booking in St. Louis, got there, the promoter asked me, do you want me to put your stuff in a dressing room? Would you like to get dressed with somebody by yourself? I told him, I said, no, I don't like being antisocial. I want to be amongst everybody else. Put me in population, like this jail or some shit.
Right.
Put me in population. Yeah, put me in population with everybody else. I want to hang out. I want to get drunk. I want to have a good time. I got in the dressing room. I hugged everybody, as I do everywhere I go.
Mm-hmm.
The assistants, the boyfriends, everybody got a hug and a kiss. Hey, how you doing? Because when you walk in there, you got a big neon sign over your head that says RuPaul's Drag Race. They're already judging you from the door.
Right.
So you have to break that ice because they're already assumed. They're not even speaking to you. You have to approach them.
Right.
But I'm that type of person, bitch. Hey, how y'all doing? Everybody don't speak at once.
Right.
You know, that's who Trinity is. You know, I don't want to be in an environment where I'm not comfortable and I feel like people are, you know, are judging me already.
Yeah.
But they do that. Got in the dressing room. You know, hanging with the girls. Some girls asked me to borrow some stuff. You know, I get free drinks. They don't. So I took some girls to the bar, got them some shots. You know, I did the show. The show went well. After the show, I went in the audience. I mingled, took pictures, danced with everybody. I had a great time in St. Louis. They partied. They had a good time. The show is over with. The club lets out. I go to the dressing room. I get my bag. My fur and suede coat is gone.
Ooh.
Nobody knows where it is. The only people who are allowed in the dressing room is the staff and the girls.
Mm-hmm.
The staff don't have bags.
Oh.
The girls do. All the girls are gone.
Oh. Mm.
So after a whole night of being pleasant and humble and my normal self, you steal my coat and it's in the dead of winter.
Mm-hmm.
In St. Louis.
Ooh. Damn.
So that was just a portion of of what, you know, of something. And then what put the icing on the cake for me is that a young lady did a competition, and in her question and answer, she made the comment, RuPaul's Drag Race girls have it so easy.
Oh.
They don't have to work for anything.
Ooh.
Girls like me travel from city to city, and we earn our livings, and we earn our names. First of all, bitch, just 2 years ago, I was, and let me confirm, still a local queen.
Uh-huh. Yes, well
I am
said.
A local uh-huh. queen. When I go back to Atlanta, I get the same pay that every other girl gets. I've never asked for a pay increase. I don't think I'm better than anybody else. When girls have came to my city, I have tucking them out to the clubs after they've done their numbers. I am a local queen.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what that local queen means. That's where it came from.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You live in this city. You perform here every week. You are a local act in this city. You are a resident of this city. So it's beyond me why that word was so offensive to people.
Mm.
But considering my aggression, right. I understand right. why they could have tucked it. Why they tucked
you
it
came out of thug style. Yeah, you yeah. wore yeah. your Bonet hat.
Yeah,
no. No lip gloss.
Now, don't get me wrong. Josh is Josh.
Right.
I can't. Josh is Josh.
Josh came out and was like, Trinity, take a seat. I'm fitting to read some bitches.
Yeah, get to know me. I'm the coolest person you'll ever meet. I have given clothes to girls on the road. I have helped girls do their makeup. I have brought girls to my hotel room. We done smoked and had a good time.
Mm.
I am the people's queen.
Right, yeah.
You get what I'm saying? I am
the people's queen.
I am the people's queen.
I'm not so, in that video, but he is.
No, but in that video, I wasn't Trinity.
Right.
And that's another thing people don't know.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I'm glad I'm here, because I get to explain myself.
Yeah.
I am two different people.
Mm-hmm.
Josh is Josh. Trinity is Trinity. So there's a separation. I would have never made that video like this.
Mm-hmm.
But him. But to my list, I'm going to make it fast.
Lady Red, the list is coming out.
The list is here, Lady Red. You ready?
Him.
Lady Red.
Let's go.
You here?
I like both of y'all. Let's go.
You see me? I see you. First, I want to address Fifi O'Hara.
Oh, right. Because Fifi came back and was like, this bitch is crazy.
Yeah. let me just say that I think Fifi O'Hara is fucking brilliant. She is by far one of the most talented queens today, in my eyes.
She's serving it.
She
hard.
Is in the epitome of drag, and her artistry is so far beyond. I don't even think she even really knows her worth. And I'm happy. First of all, I'm really pissed off because I think the bitch unfollowed me on Instagram, and I can't see the rest of the 365 days. Anybody else following CC? Because I want to see what's going on. I'm serious. I want to know what's going on. You know, I love her as a person, but I felt personally attacked because last I checked, me and Fifi had a good relationship.
Uh-huh.
We've hung out. We've, you know, had a great time together. And as my sister, I thought that if she felt what I did was wrong, that she could have reached out to me personally and said, no, bitch, you're wrong. Mm. You need to take that down now. But she didn't do that. She went against everything that I said, which in my eyes were all supposed to be positive points, and made them and turned it around and made it negative. And the video was not viral until she said something.
Mm-hmm.
But when they saw the video, they had already read her take on it.
Uh-huh.
So at that point, you see it how she sees it. And that's what made it what it was. And I felt personally attacked. It wasn't about her having an opinion. I just felt like, you're supposed to be my sister.
Mm.
And I thought I was taking up for us, our sorority, because she knows what I'm talking about.
Uh-huh.
Fifi O'Hara is extremely intelligent, and she's smart. She Olivia Pope'd my ass.
Oh, yes, she did.
She Olivia Pope'd my ass. But I'm Cookie Lyon.
Oh, okay. Oh.
So, if that was my sister and I felt like she said something wrong, I would have called her.
Right.
I would have called her, because I'm not hanging anybody out to dry, but nobody stood up for me.
Mm.
They called me and said, girl, I agree. You right. They called.
Oh, okay.
But nobody stood up for me.
Right.
Nobody was there for me. I'm by myself on this. And I stand strong in it, Johnny. I believe in everything I said, and I don't apologize for what I believe in. I apologize for the way that I delivered it.
Okay.
Because I never wanted to offend anybody, but the girls who are out there that feel that way, you know who you are.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't speak for anybody else, and I will no longer ever speak for another girl. because I see now that I'm alone in this.
Yeah.
So for now on, I'll speak for Trinity. And all I'm asking for is for people to love on me and embrace me and let me prove to you who I am. Don't judge me off of Drag Race, because the show is designed to pull the best and the worst out of you.
Right.
And unfortunately, it pulled the worst out of me.
Mm.
But there's so much good.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
I do.
But let me break it down for you.
Break it down, honey. And look good doing it.
I want to give a personal thank you to Raja, Latrice Royale, Juju B, Alyssa, Coco, just to name a few girls who have came to my local hometown bar,
mm-hmm.
where on a regular week, I'll probably make $150, $100 if it's cute. If somebody's really feeling it, you made $175, $200. Okay.
Right.
Anytime any of those girls have came, that's income tax time for me.
Right.
$500 in tips.
Uh-huh.
$600 in tips. Because these people come out to see those girls.
Right.
New faces. I know my bar. I know my patrons. I know the people. It's new faces. People who don't come out. But they're there. So they come to see them. And we all make money. I have made tons of money off of those girls. And I thank you for that. I thank you for that, bitch. This is after I was on Drag Race.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
I thank them for that, because had they not came, I wouldn't have seen that money.
Mm-hmm.
not there, not at home.
Right, not that day.
So I'm thankful for those girls who come in town. The point that I'm trying to make is when I said that, when we come to those cities and we pack up the houses, that's an advantage for you. It's putting extra money in your pocket. I'm not saying that I'm making your coin.
Mm-hmm.
But, bitch, you're making coins because I'm in the building. So what am I doing so wrong? It's just a sense of appreciation.
Sure.
I'm appreciative. I'm not speaking for nobody else. I am appreciative. So I just want people to accept me, and I just want them to embrace me. And hopefully they'll do the same for my sisters.
Uh-huh.
And my future sisters.
Yeah.
And not judge them off of the television show, because it's made to do that. It's made to make you love or hate.
That's true.
Because it's TV.
Yes.
We film for 15 hours a day. You only get to see us for 45 minutes.
Right.
15 hours.
Yeah.
45 minutes.
Mm-hmm. There it is. All right. I like to get the spirit and say, I heal you, child. All the evas is gone.
So,
yeah. All right, I think you covered it, baby. That was good. well, now let's talk about Drag Race for a minute. So, was that a rough experience when you went on? I mean, you were 22 when you went on, and all y'all kids that go on to that so young, that can be brutal.
Yeah. I've been doing drag since I was 14. My mother.
Really?
14. My mother. She's a rebel. So at the time she was a lesbian.
Uh-huh. And, oh, I like and, that. Switch it around.
Yeah, mom just likes to, you know, she just, however the wind is blowing, that's how she flows.
Okay.
And I grew up around queens. And, you know, drag queens and male leads and things of that nature. And I also was into drama and stuff like that. And I went to a drag pageant that they had at a local flea market. It was a big thing, Miss Flea Market. All the girls on the East Coast have won this competition.
Uh-huh.
And I told my mom, I was like, I can do this. I can do this.
Right.
I know I can do this because I love music. And I used to dance around the house all the time. And she was like, well, you're not old enough to do this. And I was like, well, we need to figure it out.
Oh, wow.
So she went and she bought me, I had a whole Mac case. Mind you, this is 13 years ago.
Uh-huh.
Everything you could think of for Mac, I had.
Wow.
Couldn't use one bit of it.
Uh-huh.
There's a picture that's on my Instagram. You guys, if you can find it, just post it right now.
Okay.
I look god awful. God awful. And these are all Mac products.
Right.
That I have on today that I finally learned how to use.
Well, well done. You look gorgeous.
Yeah, thank you. But, you know, she got me these things and she ordered me dresses, and I couldn't get in clubs, so she would have house pageants.
Wow. For me, and her friends would come, and other girls would come and compete, and that's how we learned. We had house pageants.
Wow.
We
house pageants.
We used things in the house. We used things in the house, sheets and whatever, and we did the competitions in the house.
Amazing.
And that's how I learned. And then when I turned 15, this is where shit gets personal. When I turned 15, I told my mom that I wanted to do drag professionally. And she was like, it's not possible. And we got into this big old thing about it. And I said, well, I'm leaving. And I left at 15. Mm. And I went to Atlanta. And when I got to Atlanta, I knew nobody but my gay father at the time. And he let me stay with him. But he was always on the road. And I needed to make money some way. So I started doing the talent shows there. Nobody knew me. Mm-hmm. Nobody questions drag queens when they walk in the door. They don't ID you.
Right.
So I was doing talent shows, and when I started doing the talent shows, I was getting better. And I started working on showcasts. I've been on probably 11 showcasts in the city of Atlanta in the 8 years I lived there. And I just started working and working and working. It wasn't until I turned 18 that they actually found out how old I was. Wow. I was working in bars that were 21 and 25 and up.
Wow.
But I was responsible. I didn't drink, I didn't smoke, I didn't indulge in adults, I didn't do any of that things. I was really scary back then. Like, I didn't do any, I just wanted to do the show. I just wanted to do the show. That was my only desire, to be on stage.
Right.
And, you know, I did the shows and I got good. And I started doing pageants. I won my first 10 pageants at 17. My first national was Miss Black Universe. I made the top 5 at 19. My first national competition I won was at 19, Miss Models Inc. I won Miss Dumar International at 20. I won Miss Sweetheart International. I've been top 5, and I just kept going. And at 25 now, you know, I sit here before you with all of these achievements. And that's why I keep saying God has been so good to me. Mm-hmm. He has really put a halo, you know, watched over me. I've had an angel on my back, because I could have went down so many wrong paths. I've been in the eyes and the mix of so many different drugs and, and prostitution and all of, and I've never indulged in any of those things. Now I smoke down.
Well, who doesn't in this studio?
I smoke down, but I've never done anything else. And I just think that that has been my saving grace.
Right.
It really has. And Drag Race is just, Drag Race was amazing after the fact.
Uh-huh.
Being there was awful.
And get into it. Tell me all about
being
it.
Being there was awful because, like I said, it's a competition where it brings out the best and the worst of you. Of course, they want us all to be fabulous.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a thing that we really all may not possess: uniqueness, nerve, charisma, and talent at that time.
Right.
You might get that shit 10 years down the line.
Uh-huh.
You know.
Right. You might have C, but not you.
Yeah.
Or have C and T,
yeah,
but we need that.
You might get that shit 10 years down the line. You may get it 10 years down the line, but everybody doesn't possess that right then and there. And that's why Bianca's so fucking fabulous to me. Because she's a walking example of uniqueness, charisma, nerve, and talent.
Uh-huh.
So, and I live for that.
Right.
And there's so many other girls who possess that. And at the time, I didn't possess all of that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I had talent.
Right.
I thought I was uniqueness.
Uh-huh.
But I thought I was unique. But the nerve to speak up for myself and try and not make excuses.
Right.
I didn't possess that. I made several excuses. And looking back at myself, I'm like, you idiot, what are you doing?
Uh-huh.
You're acting right now.
Right.
This is an act.
Yeah.
What do you mean you're not an actor? You know, but you don't get to say that to yourself until you see yourself back.
Mm-hmm. Now, there was rumblings a couple while ago, you were going to do an album. Is that still in the works?
I want to do some music. I actually want to rap. I write. I want to rap. I do write. I want to do a single. I'm going to do a single and see what the people think.
Right.
I don't want to spend all this money on an album and they don't buy it.
Uh-huh.
But as of right now, when I get back home, I'm working on some web series projects with my father, who's producing it. And that's what I'll be doing on the summertime. But honestly speaking, I want to take a break.
Uh-huh.
I want to take a break. Trinity has been going nonstop for so long.
Yeah, I mean, 14 years old to start drag, honey, that's a whole career right there.
She's been going nonstop for so long. And Trinity, there's Trinity and there's Josh. And she has been my saving grace and my supporter and my backbone for as long as I can remember. She has put food in my stomach. She has sheltered me. She has done all of these things for me. And I speak as her. I'm speaking as Josh now.
Right.
For her. She has done so much for me. And I have done nothing for myself. I left home at 15. I have not experienced life as Josh.
Mm-hmm.
I've done nothing with my life as Josh. And people say things, and I see people say online, you know, the way that I type and my vocabulary, you know, you need to educate yourself more. You need to do this. Your vocabulary sucks. And they're right.
Mm.
I have a 9th grade education. I dropped out of school.
Really?
To do drag.
Uh-huh.
Because this is something that I want. And this is me laying my life out to people. Because right. They want to know so much about you.
Right.
So here it is.
Here it is.
You know, I have a 9th grade education. That's nothing I'm proud of.
Right.
It's nothing to be proud of. My mother is extremely proud of me. Everything that I do, this for her, being on this show, is a diploma.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, it's not enough.
Right.
It's not enough. And I owe her that. I owe it to myself to further my education. I owe it to myself to complete my life. And I owe it to myself to prove to myself that I can be something other than her. I don't have to depend on her for the rest of my life to be successful. But I have done nothing other than this. I know nothing other right. than this.
9th grade dropout, drag is out all
right,
of it.
Right, and the problem for me is now, if I put her on the back burner, after her being my support system for so long,
yeah,
and I go out into the world and I fail, it was all for nothing.
Mm.
And I don't want to be a failure. I don't want to not be successful, but it's only fair to myself to prove to myself that this is not all that I have to possess. You know, this is not all that I have to accomplish in my life. So I want to go back to school. I want to build a business for myself. I want to open up a glam bar, a makeup bar for, you know, women to come and just get beautified for whatever events they have right. going on. You know, this is some things that I want to do for Josh, not for Trinity. She's set in stone. She's there.
You can always take her out of the closet, whatever you want.
I can always take her out
dust
of the closet.
Dust that wig off.
Dust the wig off and go on the road. But I can't say the same for Josh. And that's the mission. That's the mission for me. So when people attack, I understand why, but it's because they don't know. They don't know. And all I'm asking from people is to, like I said, my grandmother always says, just to love on me and be patient with me and support me and grow with me and know that I'm a work in progress, and I'm not naive to my downfalls and my mistakes. Yeah. Because I'm well aware of the things that I do. And I can tell myself, no, you were wrong. Or you can do better. Or you should do better. And if anybody out there really cares enough about me, just check on me. Just check on me, ask me how I'm doing, you know, give a helping hand, lend me some advice, positive advice, and, you know, just be patient with me. That's all I'm asking, is to be patient with me. I'm not bitter. I'm happy. I'm humble. I'm appreciative. I'm just a work in progress. I'm a work in progress. I'm human, and I'm only 25. I'm still a baby. But Trinity is 25. She's experienced the life.
Right.
Josh is still 15.
Yeah.
So I'm battling and dealing with two different worlds that I'm trying to mash together, and I'm trying to catch up with her because she's so far ahead of me.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
It does, Trinity. I think this has been a very enlightening moment here with you. What do you think, Johnny and Lady Red?
Oh my God, they're so cute.
Oh, she's way nicer than I thought. Yeah, I thought she was gonna read your ass. No, she was good.
That's a nice, I beat Lady Red rocking.
Trinity, I'm so glad you were able to come on here. Oh, thank you for this. I'm so glad you were able to come on here and clear this up. And also, I think it's very brave of you. I think the idea of getting your education together, doing that, and keeping your other spirit alive is one you should really think about. Right, Lady Red?
Yes, yes, baby. And don't be afraid to ask for help. You know what I mean? We all here in this game together. And I personally will tell you, if you call me, bitch, I'm going to answer.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, God bless Trinity K. Bonet after all. You are all wrong about her.
Trinity. I'm sweet.
She's nice. Trinity, honey, you serve her so fancy. You snatched your trophy, honey.
Oh,
yeah.
Frozen cups and hot chips. Thank you so much for this.
And you've also won yourself a lap dance. About. Trinity, thank you for being here, baby.
Thank you for having
me. I'm glad you could clear it all up, darling. We got love for you here. And we'll see you next time on Hey Queen, all right?
Yeah.
Bye.